Hello everyone, this is Gudni Bergsson here in Iceland. Greetings to you in Bolton. I'm doing this on the request from Ian Britz of the Supporters Trust and I wish you all the best with your work there. It's really important now for our supporters to stick together in those testing and difficult times, for Bolton has had a long history and we have to keep faith and have the belief that things will turn for the better, of course. So stick in there and all the best with that. But on to the questions Ian asked me to answer. First, the situation here in Iceland. We haven't had a lockdown in Iceland as such. We've had some restrictions on gatherings and sporting activities. So it's been a strange environment now for quite a few weeks. But now they are being lifted, so we're looking ahead to be able to start our season here in Iceland, and we start on 12th of June. For me personally, I've tried to keep sort of active by walking about, with the wife and the family, and doing my own bit. Although I've not been able to go to the gym or any organized sports, but. We are trying to stay active and of course I hope things are going well for you guys in Bolton and of course you have to keep safe and hopefully things will start to turn to be better back in the UK. I'm working now as president of the Icelandic FA, so it's been a really busy time for us trying to organize things in regards to our clubs. It's been quite a complex situation here, like in the UK, but we are trying to work our way through it with the government and hopefully, we will go back to normal in the next couple of months. We're looking ahead of playing England in the Nations League in September, so hopefully that can go ahead. But the footballing environment has been severely affected here in Iceland, like in the UK. So on to the questions from Ian. My sporting heroes, it's difficult. I didn't really have that many heroes that I looked up to, although I would say probably my dad. He was my role model. He played handball and football in Iceland for my old club Valur and for Iceland as well. So he is my role model. But then I really looked up to Kevin Keegan. I liked him as a player in the old days, the Liverpool side, the great Liverpool side of the 70s and the 80s. Alan Hansen I like as a defender. And then there was a player, Icelandic player, Ásgeir Sigurvinsson, who used to be one of the best players in Bundesliga, played for Bayern Munich and Stuttgart, and was voted the best player of the season there in Bundesliga in 84. So I was lucky enough then to play with him later for Iceland, and he was a fantastic player. So I would name these guys as my idols, if you like. The best player I played with, that's a tough one. There's so many good players I played with. I mean, if I start with my Spurs time, I played with Gasser, Lineker, Waddle, Gary Mabbutt, and they were really fantastic players. And the aforementioned Ásgeir Sigurvinsson for Iceland, of course, who was a great player. And I have to mention as well Arnold Gudjonsson, who was his dad of Eider. He was a really good player. But then on to the main thing, Bolton Wanderers. I mean, there was a lot of good players I played with there. But for pure talent and what they brought to the game, I suppose. I mean, JD was a special talent, of course, and Yuri Djorkaeff. I mean, they were a joy to watch, and they were really, really good players for us, and of course had great careers. But I would like to mention Per Fransson in midfield. Always gave 100% and really, fantastic player, and it was always good to have him there in front of you. He was effective, he could play, he could tackle, and he was a battler, not perhaps the quickest, but he had a quick mind. And then being a defender, defenders union, I mean, there's so many defenders which I would like to mention, and it's difficult to leave anyone out. You start with the you know, Stopsy, of course, when he was there, and Mike Whitlow, of course, you know, who I played with a lot. Mark Fiss was a good player for us when Colin Hendry came there as well. Of course, my good friend Jimmy Phillips, you know, was a good friend, and then Simon Charlton. You don't really want to pick anyone special out. Big Jerry Taggart. Was a good player, so but it was all about I think team spirit, and then we had UC and Branny in goal, Ricardo of course, and you know, it's always difficult to mention, you know, just a few, but there were obviously a lot of good players during my time. Most difficult opponents, they weren't that difficult, no, but there were quite a few really good players. I think Ian Wright, he was always at you and never gave in, and was really making things difficult with runs, and you know, he was a real fighter. So it was quite difficult to play against. And I remember Les Ferdinand as well, such a powerhouse, of course, you know, played for us as well, and you know, he was full of pace and power. And I always remember one incident especially when I thought, you know, I jumped like a salmon, I thought, and I really had the ball, and then he came from I don't know where and jumped like, you know, crazy height and won me in the air, and you know, I always remember that, funnily enough. And he wasn't the tallest, but he had so much power. But then for pure talent, I would say Thierry Henry. Although we did actually, we managed to keep him quiet at Bolton. He didn't score many against us, but you know, when he really got going, he was so fast and had so much skill, and it was a really tough, you know, when he really was at it. But for pure effort, Ian Wright always made it more difficult. And then the best games, memorable games I played, you know, for Bolton. I played over 300 games, I think 317 or 18, something like that. And there are quite a lot of games springs to mind. I think I have to mention first, you know, the playoffs, the finals, you know, both against Reading in 95 and then Preston 2001, you know, and those occasions, you know, for all the importance of it, you know, not just for the place, but for the community and for the town. And there were really special occasions, both at the old Wembley, the way that game against Reading, you know, ended up 4-3. And then, of course, the win in the Millennium Stadium, 3-0 against Preston. And those were really special games. I remember as well, really well, our wins against Man United 2 years on the trot. When we beat them at Old Trafford, and those were I think special for all of us, and for the fans as well. When United were really, you know, forced to be reckoned with, and there was a game against at Burnton Park against Spurs, you know, in the League Cup when we beat them 6-1, and you know what a game that was. By there was, I think, in 96 or 7. And I thought we were going places with this team, because we just played them, you know, off the park that night. And I remember Sol Campbell was there, but they had this really strong team, but we absolutely overrun them. And that was a fantastic night. There are a few games, of course, you know, then the last game in Burnton Park, was special for so many of us. And playoffs semi-final against West Brom, and my last game at the Reebok against Middlesbrough, you know, 2003. There was so much at stake, and it was my last game in football, and just we had to win, and we were always going to win that game. But you know, the atmosphere and the spirit of the place were really, really fantastic, and you know, that's something we have to recapture. And it was just a great, great day. The managers, the best managers for me. I didn't have that many managers, but to start off with, Terry Venables brought me to Spurs. He was a good manager, but he didn't quite get the best out of me, to be honest. Perhaps it was myself, of course, but I was playing right back more than centre half. But he brought me into the English game, and for that I will always be thankful. And we had a really good team. But looking back, you know, I think. I probably could have done better, and of course, you know, but Terry was a really good manager, and I really liked him. Now at Bolton, of course, I mean, I have to say, Big Sam, you know, brought the best out of me, I think, as a player. I was getting on a little bit, you know, 34 or 5, however old I was then, 35 probably. But he really managed to get, you know, the team and the club really going, and obviously had a great success. We had the nucleus of some good players and with good work ethics, and then some talented players like JJ and Djorkaeff coming in there. And I think, you know, we just had a fantastic unity, both with the supporters and Sam was forward thinking. You know, he was a little bit old school, but forward thinking and relied on sports science. And I think we were really, you know, a great outfit. But what I have to mention as well, I mean, Bruce Rioch, when I first came there, was, I think, a really good manager, and he really got the club going, as we know, and he was a great manager. And again, I mean, with Totti created a great team there. We played really some good stuff, and so he was good as well. And then you have to mention Phil Brown. I mean, he played his part as well. So I'm not leaving anyone out, so they were all bloody good. And then what's the last one? With the players who I keep in contact with. I mean, my best friend at the club, Jimmy Phillips, you know, I keep in touch with him, and try to keep in touch with Bolton in general. I haven't been that much in recent years, and I want to, like, to, you know, come back as soon as possible. Then, of course, with the Icelandic players, Ider Johnson and Arne Gunnar Laxson, of course, I keep in touch with them. And then the Danish players in general, I mean, and especially Bo Hansen, we always, keep in touch. Murphy, I've spoken to a few years back, since I've spoken to Per Franzen and Klaus Jensen, but there was always a good link there. But looking back, I mean, I think we had a great camaraderie. We had a really good team spirit, and if I were to meet these guys today, you know, it would just be like yesterday. That's the way football works somehow. And on the final note, to Bolton and all the supporters and to the club, you know, we've experienced a really tough time of late in recent years. I think, like I said earlier, we just have to somehow, you know, this club is almost 150 years old, and we just hopefully will see the good times, of course, come back. They will come back, and hopefully the owners with the supporters will somehow experience again this unity which we experienced for a period of time, and the good times. And I think now is the time to support our club. I think the supporters trust is a lovely idea. I hope that the town and the council and the owners and the supporters and somehow you know, recapture the spirit we had. So we just have to keep faith, and in the end, I want to wish you all, you know, all the best of times. Keep safe, keep healthy. I hope this will all clear up in the near future with the epidemic we're experiencing. My thoughts have really been with my friends at Bolton and all of the public. I had such a lovely time at Bolton. I wish you all the best, and see you soon. Thanks. Goodbye from Iceland.